Want to talk to you just a little bit today about the 7.3 Powerstroke EB valve. So if you have a 94 to 2003 7.3 Powerstroke, your turbocharger has what's known as an EB valve. The EB valve is on the back of your turbo. I want to tell you just a little bit about this turbocharger. We've got this broken down doing a Wicked Wheel video. If you want to check that out, we'll link you to it inside of this video, and also a removal and install of a 7.3 Powerstroke turbo. But let's talk about the EB valve now. So the EB valve is bolted to the backside, the exhaust housing of your turbo, not exactly like that. It is actuated, and let's look at the valve itself. The valve itself is just a metal valve. When it's open, it looks like that. When it's closed, it looks like so. It has a rod that is attached to from your turbo pedestal. Your turbo pedestal, it has an electronic actuator on here, and the actuator, it gets signal from the exhaust back pressure sensor on the motor. Then the actuator valve will actuate it open or closed, and that's just general function of it. What does it do and why is it here? Let me take this turbo off the cart. The EB valve on the 7.3 Powerstrokes serves one purpose. What it does is, in colder temperatures, it will actually close, and that will allow the more back pressure on the motor, more heat on the motor, and it will allow the motor to come up to temperature quicker. The theory on that is, up to temperature motor, truck fuels correctly, less emissions, so on. But that's what it's for. It is for the warm up of the motor. Now, what we find with EB valves, and we see this in the field on almost all 7.3 trucks, they're very, very, well, the valve itself is not really a failing component. It does fail in regard to the fact that sometimes it can get sticky in the bore and maybe not return correctly. But most of the time, the failure is in the pedestal component. The pedestal is very, very bad about leaking oil. You can see that here. This pedestal, this actuator, this solenoid actuator, the electronic portion of this is completely broken off. It's completely broken off. It's gone. It's already serving zero purpose. You know, most people like to eliminate the EB valve because it's a restriction. It might be a small restriction, but it still is a restriction. They like to eliminate it, and that's fine. What they do most of the time is they electronically unhook it, but the problem then is you've still got the leaks that happen around the actuator itself or at the pedestal. So what we really want to do is we want to just get rid of it on our truck. We have a 2001 Excursion or 2000 Excursion that we're doing a Wicked Wheel test on. Breaking the turbo down, we found the oil leaks, we found our EB valve to be sooted up. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace this. Now, here's where Garrett enters. Garrett offers a non-EB pedestal and valve for the back side of your 7.3 turbo. We've got these for the 94 to 97s, the early 98s, or the early 99s, I'm sorry, and then the 99 and a half to 2000 and 3 mile trucks, and that's what this is. This is the setup for the 99 and a half to 2003. This is just simply a back plate for our turbo that has no EB valve in it. It is high flow, and then we have a no EB pedestal. There's no solenoid here. You just have straight oil pass through here, straight to your turbocharger, which is perfect for what we're wanting to do. We're wanting to get rid of the EB valve. We don't want that failure anymore. We really don't need the back pressure on the motor for quicker engine warm up. It's just not going to be necessary for our application here. We're going to be just fine. This is Kentucky. Winters don't get too cold here, so we're good to go there. So the EB valve, these are sold separately. We have these comboed together where you can get them both if you want them both. There's no reason really to buy them separately. You can buy the valve itself, get rid of the valve, and unhook your pedestal. If you've got a new pedestal, we don't suggest that. Just go ahead and buy the valve and itself. We also have this comboed with the install kit. Neither one of these parts comes with any seals or bolts that you're going to need for install. These are just the blank pedestals. You will need to buy the installation kit for the turbo. It is a Garrett part number. We've got it combo with these as well. So all three pieces come in the set. and that will get you all the O-rings between the block and the pedestal, and then between the pedestal and the turbocharger. So with that being said, we wanted to give you this and show you how it shops on our website, talk to you about the functionality of what the valve itself does, and why, if you are in the proper climate, we would suggest for you to get rid of it, especially if you're doing an installation like we're doing today. So I'm Wade from Thoroughbred Diesel. We appreciate you watching this video. If you've got a question about this installation, or I'm sorry, about this product or any of our other products or any of our installations, you can just give us a call, like and subscribe to our channel. And if you've got any stories about your EB valve or your pedestal failing on you, leaks or whatnot, put them down in the comments below. Check the other videos that are related to this video in particular out, our installation video of the turbo, and then our installation of the wicked wheel. Thanks for watching.